So as I had said in my last video, today I'll be discussing all about the Commonwealth, Commonwealth dream, the difference between a Commonwealth dream and a Commonwealth nation, and why are some nations still Commonwealth dreams. So hello everyone, Annyeonghaseyo, Namaste, Konnichiwa. This is Vishal and welcome to our channel Indica Central. Over here we discuss the world history and current affairs from India's perspective. The term Commonwealth was first used in a historical document known as the Balfour Declaration of 1926. This declaration made all the four British dominions, which were Canada, Australia, New Zealand and South Africa, as autonomous communities within the British Empire, in no way subordinate to one another, though united by a common allegiance to the British monarch and members of the British Commonwealth of Nations. So the British monarch was originally the head of the Commonwealth and the sovereign for all these four dominions. Now, in 1931, the British government passed the Statute of Westminster, which gave parliamentary independence to these four dominions. In 1922, after the end of the Irish Civil War, Ireland was split into two parts, with the southern portion becoming independent and a dominion with the British Crown as the head of the state, much like what Australia is today. However, in 1948, they wanted to become a republic and they passed the Republic of Ireland Act 1948, which was enacted or came into force on 18th April 1949. Now, as a republic, Ireland could not have the British monarch as its head of state, and therefore it left the Commonwealth. On 15th August 1947, India became independent and a dominion. However, the Indian government wanted to become a republic but retain its Commonwealth membership. Now this had a problem, which was solved only in the London Declaration of 1949. This declaration was drafted by none other than Mr. V.K. Krishna Menon, who later became the Defence Minister of India during the Indochina War in 1962. This declaration gave two things. Firstly, it allowed republics and indigenous monarchies to become members of the Commonwealth. Secondly, it renamed the British Commonwealth as the Commonwealth of Nations. This declaration was the foundation stone of the modern Commonwealth. This paved the way for countries like India and Pakistan to join it as republics, and later countries like Malaysia to join it as indigenous monarchies. Today, the Commonwealth is the world's second largest multinational organization, just behind the United Nations. Its objective is to promote democracy, and its largest event is the Commonwealth Games. It has 54 member states, with two members, Mozambique and Rwanda, being a part despite having any links to the British Empire. Their territories were not a part of the empire, either in full or in part. Also, all the former British colonies are not the members of the Commonwealth either. For example, I gave you the example of Ireland earlier. Now Zimbabwe, which was previously a part, later withdrew from the Commonwealth for violating the Harare Declaration, which was ironically signed in its own capital city. This declaration set the objectives of the Commonwealth to world peace, economic development, the rule of law, and an end to racial discrimination. USA is also not a member of the Commonwealth despite being a British colony, because it became independent in 1776 when there was no such concept. Maldives also was first withdrawn from the Commonwealth but later rejoined it. Also, the British protectorates and mandates such as UAE, Iraq and Palestine are not the members of the Commonwealth either. Commonwealth dream is a kind of Commonwealth member who still has the British monarch, who is currently Queen Elizabeth II, as their head of state. It is a subset of a member of the Commonwealth, and there are 16 such Commonwealth dreams today. Barring the three European origin Commonwealth dreams, that is Australia, Canada and New Zealand, it is surprising that there are several others who still follow this concept. They usually maintain this for imperial honors. If we just look at a pattern, they are usually countries who are very small or became newly independent, that is after 1970s. When the founders of Papua New Guinea, when it became independent from Australia, were asked, they said that they chose to retain the status of the Commonwealth realm because it had imperial honors and because a small country like theirs could not afford to maintain its own ceremonial system. There are several countries who were first Commonwealth realms but later became republics, such as the Gambia, but there is no case the other way around. So I hope this video was of some help. It was helpful to answer your questions and teach you something new. If you like this video, please press the like button, please share and subscribe to our channel Indica Central. Also, press the bell icon to get the latest updates of all our videos. Thank you. Thanks for watching.